We're going to start with the five foundation keys. The way it'll work with the book, I'll be back at the end of the 5 weeks. There are exercises within the book. I'm going to talk about the five foundation keys, but the first three keys, there's an exercise associated with it. Throughout the next 4 weeks, I want you all to work on those exercises. So the five foundation keys. Five foundation keys, very important. Number one, you got to have that mindset to be successful in college, period. And I always relate it to these. Number one, starting with the why. Can anybody tell me what that means to them? Having a why. Yes, ma'am.
Having a reason you're doing what you're doing.
The reason you're doing what you're doing. You want to add to that?
Having a purpose.
That's exactly what I'm headed towards. So for me, until I was 28, I didn't start thinking about really having a direct purpose. And I relate this to the 3 points of purpose. So in the book, you'll see the three pops. The 3 points of purpose. Number one, you got to think about the people who sacrifice for you. Now, I told y'all about my mama and the woman who raised me because she didn't have to do what she did for me. She could have left me where I was. I got blessed and got raised by a woman that took me out of those circumstances. And look, when I was 5 years old, I broke my hip. I was in a body cast. I told y'all she was on dialysis. She had to carry me around with one arm. When she moved to Texas, she could have left me in Louisiana. So I said that to say, you got to think about the people who are sacrificing for you. I was talking to the group earlier. Parents dropped them off. Some of the parents stayed here, driving all the way to PV. Your parents don't have that. Nobody was taking me to no summer programs. Those distractions, the distractions will be there. It's going to be somebody that's going to want you to come shack up, going to want you to start spending the night over there. And then they got an 8 o'clock class and they go into class, but you tripping and you slipping. You got to think about how much your parents really sacrificed for you to get here. Whenever they got to go to work, it ain't no, I got to take days off or I'm going to be late, because if not, or if they do, what's going to happen? In those shoes, their shelter, their food, everything that they've been sacrificing to get you here, it'll be all for naught. So you got to think about, number one, the people who sacrificing for you. Then number two, how many of y'all got younger siblings? You got to think about the people who looking up to you, especially if you got a younger sibling, a niece, a nephew, anybody that's looking up to you. Whenever you stepped in high school as a ninth grader, if the 12th grader's acting a fool, you're going to think that's cool. So every time somebody is looking up to you, you got to think about that. Whenever I worked in financial aid, I hated being a counselor, working with a family coming in as a freshman. And then in the spring, they don't come back. But when you're here with your family, you got the younger brother, the younger sister, everybody excited. I know you had a live graduation party. How does it look if your little sibling or your cousin or your niece or your nephew got to see you come back at home? And they saying, well, what's up? I thought you was in college. And you got to tell them, well, I got caught up. I got susceptible to these distractions. And it's not that you can't be successful once you go through adversity, but you don't want to have to go through that. So number one, you got to attach yourself to a purpose. You got to think about the people who sacrifice for you. You got to think about the people who are looking up to you. And most importantly, you got to think about what it is you want to accomplish. I spoke at this medical conference last summer. They had 400 kids from across the country. And they told them only 10% of them was going to make it. Blew my mind. Because I'm like, I thought this was the 10%. And I said that to say, you got to think about what it is you want to do and what you want to accomplish, because you got to get to it right now. It's competitive out here. Ain't nobody going to give you nothing just because you black or just because you at a minority school. You got to work for it, because there's somebody else working just as hard. They grades where it's supposed to be. Somebody want that scholarship and they grades where it's supposed to be. That essay better. It's competitive out here. So you got to be in tune with what you want. Your parents should motivate you. Your younger siblings should motivate you. But number one, you got to think about what it is you want to do. And if you think about what it is you want to do, that should be your top motivation. So you got to think about the why. And in the book, I have an exercise where they ask you a couple of questions that will help you establish a why. Number one, think about the people who love you. Think about the people who you love. Think about what it is you want to accomplish in this world. Answer those questions. And whenever you're able to answer those questions, trust me, you got a why. You got a purpose.